I consider this tool made by Stihl to be essential for anyone that's repairing two-stroke engines as well as four-mix engines. In fact, it can mean the difference between success and failure when diagnosing running issues in these machines, and the amount of frustration it can save, not to mention a huge repair bill if your engine seizes because one wasn't used, goes to show that it really pays to have one. I see it everywhere, people using the wrong tool for the job. And in this case, that wrong tool is a piece of rubber inner tube. It's used to create an airtight seal between the carburetor and the intake manifold to do a pressure and vacuum test on a two-stroke and four-mix engine. And I know I have in the past, and it's caused me endless tail chasing, frustration, and a huge amount of time too. You see, one critical area where air leaks can occur and therefore destroy these engines is the intake manifold block. Although there are many iterations of them, the one takeaway here is that they can all be prone to air leaks. Typically that can be either through warping of the plastic, or if they're made from rubber, compressing over time and no longer sealing. What many people do when it comes to pressure and vacuum testing their engine to see, for example, if the oil seals are in good condition or if they're leaking, is they'll place a piece of that rubber inner tube between the carburetor and the intake manifold to seal off that side of the engine. They'll place another piece of rubber onto the exhaust side between the muffler and the exhaust port, and then add or remove air. However, this is a really bad idea, because what that rubber can do is actually take up any clearance from, for example, a warped intake manifold, or maybe compressed rubber intakes that therefore would otherwise leak if the rubber wasn't there. And that's why this small block-off plate from Stihl is so important. It replicates the hard, flat surface of the carburetor, which normally seals against a small gasket, ensuring that if the leak occurs with the carburetor in place, it will show itself when used with the block-off plate. So now let's test it by using a pressure and vacuum tester by MightyVac. And I've put links to this and that block-off plate in the description below for you. So we'll do the first test using that rubber inner tube, and having applied that pressure, you can see that the needle is holding steady, and that if we add soapy water, there's no bubbles around that mating face. And therefore, because of this, you can see how easy it is to assume that that engine is now airtight. As you'll see now, when we repeat this test with the block-off plate, which is exactly the setup that it would be if the carburetor was in place when the engine's running, it's now leaking. And one nice and convenient bonus is that this adapter doesn't just fit Stihl machines or very specific models, it covers the vast majority of two-stroke outdoor power equipment, as well as the four-mix engines by Stihl. And once again, I've put Amazon links to the block-off plate, the pressure and vacuum tester, and all other tools that I've used in today's video in the description below for you. And it's worth mentioning, you will need a small piece of fuel hose to be able to attach it to the barb. The next step is to tune the engine, and I've got a video covering that topic up here for you next.